Excited to finally update you guys on my progress for my very first NaNoWriMo novel and you know, where I am right now, how things have been going, if it's been a challenge or a struggle at all, and just in general how I've been feeling about it. So I thought it would be fun to approach this video as kind of like a day in the life of NaNoWriMo. Most of you probably are familiar, but if you're not, NaNoWriMo is National Novel Writing Month, when everyone who participates sets out to write a 50,000 word novel in the month of November, so 30 days. So it's a very small amount of time to be writing a novel. It's definitely a challenge, I would say. I've never written a novel in such a short amount of time before, and there are definitely things, there are mental tricks and a lot of logistical things that come into play when you're so constrained as far as time, you know. So the weekend that I was filming this, I was actually wrapping up some changes and some formatting and stuff to my last novel that I am sending out to betas now and waiting on beta feedback, yay. That was one of the activities that took up some of my time. So the next day, my husband and I took a drive out to the Talamina Byway. So there is a state park that sits between Tallahena, Oklahoma and Mena, Arkansas. And so we drove all the way through that state park, and it was just so beautiful. It was so nice to see you know, the fall colors of the trees and everything. That was one of my resolutions this month, was to spend time outside and to actually get to enjoy the fall weather, because, you know, where I live, it just, it's very rare to have really nice, pleasant days. And so yeah, that was one of the things that I really wanted to do. So my very first day doing NaNoWriMo, I was definitely nervous to get started. It was strange working on an entirely new project, even though I've been outlining and I've been, you know, really brainstorming this story for, you know, a couple of years, to be honest. It's been percolating in my mind for a while. There's a huge difference between just these generalities that you scribble on post-it notes or, you know, in a notebook or something, and actually sitting down to flesh out the scene. So it was definitely strange sitting down to write a brand new story. I had to tell myself, just, you know, and I've been telling myself to, you know, silence my inner editor and just like switch off that judgmental voice in my head that's like, you know, this sucks, basically. Like, no one's gonna wanna read this. You know, it's gonna take so much work cleaning up, and, you know, all of the, I'm sure a lot of other people have these same thoughts in their head. And it's hard. It just really stunts your creativity when you're second guessing yourself with everything that you write. But I just have to, every day that I sit down to write, remind myself, this is the rough draft and it's allowed to suck. It just is, you know, that's what rough drafts are for. I've said before, for that, and this is my way of describing the various draft phases, the various phases of your novel, is the rough draft is like the bones phase, where you're really just getting the bare bones, the bare essence of the story out there, the basic plot. And then the second draft, the revision, is really the muscles phase, where you start, at least for me, this is how it's turned out, is where you start to get more of those motivations in there, and characters' personalities really start coming out more and influencing the story, and a lot more of those kinds of conflict and all of those things that make a story compelling. That's really when that stuff starts getting injected in there. And then the second revision is really the more of the skin. It might take you a few more drafts to really get to a completed, you know, product, but by the third draft, from my experience, is really more when you have a better sense of your overall story and you feel better about it. And so if anyone else is out there and they're still working on they've only ever written a rough draft, or this is their very first draft, hopefully that's encouraging to you, because I've definitely found that to be the case. And yes, there is a lot of work, you know, in your next draft, cleaning it up, but don't worry about that for right now. Just know that you're doing good work. But anyway, that was a tangent. All that to say that, yeah, it's I've definitely had to push myself and just to remind myself that this is, I'm doing what I'm supposed to be doing right now and just pounding out the story. And it's okay if I'm not really connecting necessarily to my characters or really feeling their personalities. That for me, at least, this is pretty typical of a rough draft. And that stuff I know will come later, so it's okay. So as of the day that I'm filming this, I've reached just over 18,000 words, and I'm feeling really good about the number of words that I've been able to produce every day. My only concern at this point is making sure that I get to the end of the novel by the time I hit 50,000 words. I really need to focus more on getting more scenes done than more words. So yeah, that's the only thing at this point. And one thing that I'm interested to see is in the book that I was telling y'all that I read, No Plot, No Problem by Chris Beatty, he was talking about how when you hit the 20,000 word mark, that is like the major slump for most writers. He says to get out of the 20,000s as soon as possible, because once you're out of that, once you're out of those 10,000 words, your motivation comes back and it's not as hard. But, and I think some of that has to do with, you know, the muddy middle that people talk about, that middles are just kind of hard. Most people have a sense of how they want their novel to start and how they want their novel to end. But there's this spot in the middle where you kind of feel like you're out in like no man's land. It can be kind of tricky to make sure that you have enough going on, because, you know, the middle is where most of your story happens. So one thing that I am doing that might be a little bit different is I'm not using the recommended 1667 words per day to hit the 50,000 words by the end of November. I actually decided when I was planning out the month that I really wanted to finish before Thanksgiving, because I know myself and I just know that, you know, we're gonna be meeting up with family and stuff. I just know that from Thanksgiving on, I'm probably not going to be writing. And so I wanted to plan ahead for that. And so what I did is I calculated, you know, the days that I was planning to write, and I came out with just over 1,800 words a day. And I actually downloaded the NaNoWriMo scheduling calendar that they had. So I'll show you all how I am tracking my word count goals. So my daily goal is 1,851, but then every day I just calculated the running total of what every day should be. That way I could have a better sense of where I am and just make sure that I'm staying on track. And then another thing that I'm doing that probably isn't like super necessary, but I'm using a Kanban board because I really like the visual of being able to see these are all of the words that I need to complete, and then being able to move them into process, and then being able to like move them into the complete category when I'm finished. What I did was I broke it down into 5,000 word increments, and so every 5,000 words I get to move it over to the complete column. So that's been really nice to see those numbers like dwindling down, just like a visual thing, just for me to feel good about myself. Really not necessary, but I don't know. So I also use the Kanban board for other things. You know, if I'm waiting on someone to send me something, or someone has sent me something and I need to review it or send feedback or whatever, I use it for those things to kind of track what I'm supposed to be doing. But also when I have new tasks, I can add them to the TBD column. So one of the realizations that I've made ever since starting NaNoWriMo is that I think my writing process is a little bit different from some people or a lot of people's. I have never been a sprinter, a writing sprinter before. I have always been more of a slow and steady wins the race kind of a writer. One thing that I didn't realize was that a lot of writers, especially in regards to NaNoWriMo, is really what I'm talking about, that people use sprints or kind of rely on sprints to get their words for the day. For me, it's always been about, this is the amount of time I have to write, and I set that time, I create that time for myself, and I just write. I write for as long as I have, and then when I'm out of time, I'm done. But what I've noticed is that a lot of other writers will say, no, I'm gonna write for 15 minutes, and they'll do a sprint, and then they'll go and do other things, and then they'll come back and they'll do a sprint for maybe 20 minutes, and then they'll go and do other things. And that's just not my process at all. I've just never done that. You know, no judgment or anything. I've just never done it. And for me, I just have a hard time taking my mind out of it when I'm in the zone, and when, cause it takes me a second to warm up and get into it. And then I'm in the zone and I'm writing. For me to get myself out of it and go do something else, only to come back and try to get back into it, it feels less productive to me. You know, it feels like, well, why would you take yourself out of it if you can just keep writing, you know? So that was one of my resolutions for NaNoWriMo, was to try sprints, because I've heard so many people talk about it, and I thought, well, that could be really helpful if, you know, I'm ever in the position where I need to get something done in a short amount of time, maybe I'm on deadline. You know, I just wanted to see if I could improve my writing speed. So that's really how I was approaching sprints. It was more about an exercise in learning to write faster. And so far, with the time that I've given myself to work to write in the mornings, I'm able to hit my word count goal by the end of my morning writing session, and I don't really have a need to do writing sprints like throughout the day, later on in the day. And then I don't really have much of an incentive to try to do sprints, you know, in the evening or during my lunch hour or whatever, other than, you know, just to learn to write faster. That's really the only incentive for me at this point in the game. I definitely want to keep an open mind and try new things. You know, this whole NaNoWriMo experience for me has been about trying new things. But yeah, the morning writing sessions have so far been a success. So I would really recommend, I know it's not for everybody, but for me, it really has been a game changer to get up in the morning to write. I did not used to be a morning person at all. I hated getting up early. You know, I wanted every extra minute of sleep that I could get. But it really, you know, it just started to become the only time in my day when I knew for sure that I could write, that I could dedicate that time to writing. And it kind of became this like special, like private time of my own, you know, when it's just quiet and no one's talking to me and I don't have to think about anything else. I can just dedicate my mind solely to writing. And that really has just, that's changed everything for me, to be honest. And so if you are struggling with your word count, I really would recommend, if you're not, to try to wake up a little bit earlier and get some writing in. But I will say that I'm really, really glad that I made the effort to put together an outline before I started. Honestly, I don't know where I would be right now if I didn't have my outline, because every morning I literally sit down, I pull up my outline, I see what scene I'm writing, and then I get started. But one thing that I've really enjoyed is the little badges that they give you on the NaNoWriMo website. They have ones for every time when you hit certain thresholds, word count thresholds, and then when you update your progress several days in a row. Oh, another thing that I wanted to mention is my the words per minute, because this goes with the sprints, because my intention is to learn to write faster. And right now I'm about, some days I'm as low as 18 words a minute, but my fastest has been about 23 words a minute. So I'm hoping to get that up, we'll see. But all in all, I'm feeling really good about this story. I know that I'm gonna feel so accomplished when I finish this rough draft in less than a month. And not every day has been a good writing day, you know? Some days I get to the computer and I'm really just kind of going through the motions of the scene and just, you know, the plot that I had envisioned. And like people always say, you can work with something that's messy, but you can't work with something that's incomplete. So what I try to tell myself on the days where I just don't feel like writing anything is that everything's fixable, you know, and it's just about getting it out there, and it doesn't need to be wonderful. It doesn't need to be what I envisioned in my head even. It just, you know, has to be words on the page, and yeah, there's always the next draft. But one other thing I wanted to mention is reading. Reading has been so, so helpful for me as far as my creative energy and just having that inspiration to write. I noticed that when I'm not reading fiction, that it becomes a lot harder to write and the words just don't come as easily. Because I've been reading a lot of nonfiction recently and I've noticed a difference in my writing. And so that's one of my resolutions, is to get back into reading fiction. And so I'm gonna read something for fun, just something light and you know, no pressure on myself or anything like that. But if you're interested in following my progress, I've been doing daily check-ins with my word count on Instagram. Okay, so I think that's all for my NaNoWriMo check-in. Thank you so much for watching. Don't forget to subscribe before you leave if you haven't already, and I'll see y'all next time. Bye.